Hello everybody, Napkin99 here, and welcome back to the Minecraft Let's Play series. So, surprise surprise, I have not done any mining off camera, as most YouTubers do. First, I wanted to actually explore a little bit of the area around here. Specifically, I saw a shipwreck. I'd like to see if we can get some bamboo or something, because I kind of want to get some little temporary farms going while we go mining. So if we get some bamboo, we can grow some of that. And I also want to find an azalea tree and go down into a lush cave and get some of the plants from there. So our shipwreck is kind of hidden in the kelp over here. We're going to boat over there so we don't have to get poisoned by fish or worry about drowned, potentially. So let's see what we got in here. Got some paper. Looks like there might just be that one chest in this one, unfortunately. Actually, there's magma blocks on this. It looks like this is supposed to be one of those sunken villages. Yeah, there's some ruins down there as well. There should be loot in here, I think. Yep. Buried treasure map. We'll definitely take that. I'm actually going to follow this buried treasure map before we get too far here, because it looks like it's actually back towards spawn, so we'll go check that out. Alrighty, and what have we got in here? A diamond, that's good. Bunch of iron, gold, emeralds. Heart of the sea is always good. Not too bad. I think this might be the only stack of bamboo in this whole jungle. It's not a very big jungle. This is the only part that's like actual jungle. The rest is like jungle edge, which is rather interesting. So I brought two cows over from that plains biome, and I'm just keeping them in here for now until I can figure out a better spot. I'm actually going to break these so they don't end up walking into it and suffocating. Well, I couldn't find an azalea tree, so we're going to head probably deeper into our caverns here and see if we can maybe find a lush caves here, or dripstone caves, because we could use some dripstone as well. Alright, gotta be a little careful about this one. There's a dungeon right here, right next to this giant pit of lava. And it sounds like there's a lot of zombies in here. I think we're good now. Got some diamond horse armor, a music disc. And some gold horse armor. We still have a lot of cave to light up. Just saying. Truthfully, I think we're just going to jump down and make a mad dash for as far as we can go and see if we can find a lush cave or a dripstone cave, because we still need that. So let's get running. Maybe stop for some diamonds. Just keep running. Oh boy, stop running there. Yep, let's head back up. So I am back out of the caves, and you may notice it's a bit noisy around here, because I got those two cows down here. I've started breeding them together. We've got a bit of a cow farm going here, and then I've also got some chickens in here. So I have gotten enough diamonds to make a full set of diamond armor, as well as a couple of tools. We have a few extras. I'm not quite sure what I want to do with them yet, so I'm just saving them for now. So we almost have enough stuff to make our full enchanting setup, just waiting for a few more cows to grow up. But anyways, I have come up with a base idea that kind of makes use of the caves here. So I want to set up, starting in that giant cavern that we found in the last episode. So here we are in the cavern. And I've kind of mined out a little area where I want to build my storage room. So this will be kind of the entrance right here. So our storage will be right by the entrance. So basically it's this little circle room. And we're going to have chests on the walls for the most part. And I think we'll have a doorway over here, because I want to have my portal room over here. It's going to be kind of big, so it'll take up some of this open space. That sign over there is because I had a slime spawn over there, so I think there's a slime chunk somewhere over there. As for the build design of our base, I'm thinking it's kind of a mix of the futuristic modern lab type thing I was talking about in the last one, and also making use of this cave and some of the new blocks, like the moss and the other plants and stuff. So I'm thinking throughout this cavern, we have kind of like a river flowing. And it's gonna fall down like waterfalls and stuff down into this area. And then we're gonna have like moss and other flowers and trees and stuff on the edges of it, as well as our buildings kind of built into the edges and around the walls. So I think it should be pretty cool. As for the blocks we're using for the buildings, I'm thinking mostly white concrete with a mix of some of the polished deep slate to kind of break it up a bit. And then each of the different sectors of our base is going to have a different color. So I think our storage room is going to be blue, and anything that has to do with storage will be blue. So if we build a bulk storage, I'll probably do another blue building somewhere around here. There's also going to be a magic section, which will be purple. That'll include our nether portal as well as our library for storing enchanted books. We'll have a red section somewhere for villagers. We'll have an orange one for our super smelter and other utilities, and probably like dripstone and lava farm and stuff like that. We'll have a yellow section for animals. That'll be like our cow farm, sheep farm. We'll probably have an apiary around here somewhere for bees. Then there's the green sector, which will obviously be plants, so sugarcane, trees, anything like that. And then we will also have a black sector, which will be our mob farm and possibly like a slime farm, stuff like that. So not quite sure where everything's going yet. I've still got some planning to do, but I want to get some storage in place first. So obviously with our base plan changing from what I had originally planned, that means my episode plans have kind of changed a bit. So I'm still trying to kind of navigate that. We ran into an aquifer over here. I think when we're building in the walls, especially for bigger projects like tree farm and mob farm, we're probably going to run into that a bit. So I do want to get sponges at some point. I did find an ocean monument fairly close to spawn when I was boating around earlier, so we'll have to take that on at some point. But we're also obviously want to get good picks, probably get a beacon set up. So we have quite a bit of work to do before we can really do anything in this base. And as well as that, concrete is not the easiest thing to get. I mean, it's fairly easy, but it takes a bit of work. And if we want a bunch of gravel, we'll probably go to the bottom of the ocean, which means we're going to need water gear. So we have a little bit of setup to do before we can really get going on this base. Anyways, I'm going to get this storage room set up off camera because I'm sure you guys don't want to watch me sorting all my random crap that I've picked up. Alrighty, so we have our storage pretty much set up here. I have a gap here because this is where our entrance is going to be. It's going to be a little diagonal entrance because I'm thinking the entrance to our base is probably going to be some sort of waterfall coming down here. So then this will give us easy access. Then we also have an opening here because our nether portal room is going to be over there, and that'll be a good room to have connected to our storage room. So otherwise, I have all of my organic stuff over here, like wood, plants, tools, armor, and then we got all of our stone items over here, our ores, redstone stuff. Got a bunch of building blocks, mob drops, friendly mob drops. And then our interdimensional stuff, so like netherrack and endstone and all that, is over here. So that's usually kind of how I organize my storage room. Usually no specific place for each wall, but usually I have the same stuff together. Anyways, next up, I want to get a temporary mob farm set up on the surface, but the design I want to use requires a little bit of quartz, so we're gonna have to go to the nether. So we're just going to set up a little temporary portal over here. I need building blocks. Alrighty, so if we light this and we put on a gold helmet so that we're safe from piglins, We're gonna hop through, hopefully not die. We'll see what's waiting for us on the other side. Number one tip, never move from your portal until the Nether has loaded in case there's gravel like that, because that could have been dangerous if that had nothing below it. Alright, so it looks like we have Basalt Delta over here, and I hear a ghast. Oh god. The ghast is over there. First try! Ouch. Okay. There's another ghast somewhere. Yeah, there's Soul Sand Valley over there, so we need to be careful. Probably head away from- Oh, that's right above us. There's quartz right above us, too. And that's what we came for. So let's get it and not die. Just need a little bit, and then we're good to go. Alright, we're heading back through. Before ghast fireballs or gravel underneath us. Alrighty, so it is finally time to make our mob grinder. So we are up at Y221 here. Nothing super specific. So if you have two stacks of scaffolding and just keep spamming it at the bottom, eventually that'll build up to 128 blocks, which is how high you need to be above the ground to make sure that mobs won't spawn below and affect your spawn rates up here. So that's just a quick little easy trick to get up there. Anyways, I've already set up the little collection system. We're not doing anything fancy right now because we're pretty low on iron. So we just have it going into two different chests here. So our drop chute is going to be 3x3, and we're going to need to build that up 23 blocks. So our mob farm is going to use up pretty much all of these materials. I'm not sure quite how many building blocks we're going to use, but we may need to get more, but hopefully this should be enough. I just kind of scrounged together whatever I had. I went to the Nether, got a little bit of netherrack since it's easier to break. And we have 30 dispensers and 30 buckets because we're going to be doing a 3-layer version of this farm. So we are going to be doing a design I saw on one of iJevin's videos, and I'll leave a link to that in the description. So I'm going to try to kind of show you guys how to do it, but this isn't my farm, so just be aware I'm not trying to take credit for it or anything. So we're going to put our scaffolding up here, 23 blocks, if we can place it on here somehow. Okay, we may have to put a block under it. So we'll go up 22 blocks from that netherrack. So that should be 23 blocks to fall on to these hoppers. And you may want to do one less, actually, because there is a small chance that they fall from a block higher up in the mob farm, so then they'll die on the ground. But if that's not a big problem to you, then just go 23. So I will probably actually remove one up there and go 22 blocks. But from that, we're going to make a little tube around this. We can cut corners here. And we actually don't want this bottom block. I'm just placing it so we have room to go from there. So if we get inside of here, we can start building this up. And then we can remove this bottom block. And then we're just going to build this up all the way up to where our scaffolding goes. So once we're up here, we're going to want to create a water path for our mobs to go. So we're going to put another layer of blocks around this edge and the one across from that. And then this over here is going to go up one block. It's going to create a little ring around this. They should have something looking like that at the moment. And then this is going to extend and be 8 blocks long. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we're going to build a wall around that. So this is going to be a big platform, and this will have water on it. We're going to do the same thing on the other side here. And then we're going to build this wall up around here, just one block higher, so that the mobs won't jump back onto the spawning platforms. And once you do that, you should have the path for your water all laid out. So now we're going to build the spawning platforms. So these are going to be 6 long. 3, 4, 5, 6. We're going to place a block for the wall, and then a block on the back for the redstone. And we're just going to do that all the way down here, and then this will have wall going around it yet again. We'll just make that too tall. And again, we'll go ahead and do the same thing on the other side. So once you've done that, it should look something like this. And obviously I ran out of netherrack, so it's going to be a pretty ugly farm, but it's temporary, so we'll do what we can. So now what you want to do is you want to get your dispensers in place. So there's going to be one here. You're going to skip a block and go in, then skip 3 blocks, do another one, and just keep doing that all the way down the line. Should be 5 dispensers on each side. And then it lines back up with 1 block between the edge. So your dispensers should go there, then you'll do that on the other side. And then you'll want to fill them with buckets of water. So we're just going to make a little temporary infinite water source here so we can fill all these buckets easily. I also recommend putting some torches on the ground here, because once you start building a ceiling over this mob, they're going to be able to start spawning if you're high up enough and far enough away from the platform. So now pretty much you can just stack this design as many layers as you want. I'm just going to do 3 because that works pretty well from my experience. I've actually built this farm in a couple of worlds, and that's why I use this design, because I've always had pretty good luck with it. It's not too hard to make. So I'm going to stack this up 3 times, and I will see you guys up top. So before we actually do the redstone on the top, we want to make sure that the water doesn't flow off of these edges, because this is only 6 blocks long. And the reason we do it 6 blocks long instead of 8 is so that the mobs are more likely to get pushed over, because they may hang on the edge a little bit if it's at the very extent of the water stream, so we'll just make sure to push them over. So you can block the water by either using signs or open fence gates. I just did signs because they're a little cheaper. So we're going to place these all along the edge here like this. We're going to do that on both sides for all 3 layers. And now that we've got those signs in place, we just have a few more to place. Just 3 right here to stop this little bit of water from flowing. And then 3 right here to stop this bit of water flowing. So we don't actually need signs right here for this water, because this is 8 blocks long, so it'll reach the end. And that should be it for signs. So now we're just going to make another temporary water source, because I forgot that I still needed it. And we're going to get our water over here. So should just have to place it every other block, and then I'll fill in sources there. Then this will flow right to the edge. And we'll go ahead and do the same on the other side. And then we'll go ahead and get these little bits going like so. And brick our last little scaffolding in the waterway here. And then here, I recommend putting a full thing of scaffolding above this hole, so that when we turn the mob farm on, you can escape and get down and do the stuff we need to do down below without having mobs fall all over you and probably end up blowing up your farm if a creeper spawns. So up top here, we're going to go to one edge and we're going to make a hopper clock. So just make these 2 hoppers point into each other. Then we're going to get a redstone comparator going from each of those into a block, into a dust, which then goes into sticky pistons, and then a redstone block here, and we'll have redstone dust going off this way. From here, we're going to put a redstone dust leading off of this one, into a repeater on 3 ticks, another one on 3 ticks, a redstone dust, another 3 ticks, another 3 ticks, a block, a redstone torch, a sticky piston, and a block going into that. And then we'll just put a repeater here going into this block. Then from this block, we're going to put a repeater. We're going to extend our redstone dust one extra than we need to. You could go off from here, but we have this hole here. And then you're going to place 5 repeaters, all on max 4 ticks. The redstone dust, and we're going to loop it back around. Like so. And then another 5 repeaters on 4 ticks. Then we'll connect this redstone dust here with a repeater here to block the signal from going back the way it came. And then we'll just go off the edge. So from this edge, we're going to want to connect our redstone down to the lines that we made before on the ends. So I believe we'll go like this. Actually, I think we're on this block here. Okay. So we'll connect it over here. And this should loop around. Yep, there we go. And we're just going to connect it and make sure we do a repeater so we don't lose the signal. Then at each of these dispensers, we're going to want to put a block. And then pointing into each of those blocks, a repeater. And then just connect all those repeaters with redstone dust. And also make sure that your sides over here are lit up so no mobs spawn on the outside here if you are using it at nighttime. So I'm going to go ahead and connect all of these up to the dispensers. So I've got all the dispensers hooked up, and our farm is ready to go, except for one thing I just wanted to mention quick. You probably want to put trapdoors on these hoppers and around the edge of the rim here. This kind of prevents the mobs from being able to see you, and if there are any baby zombies, they won't be able to get out, and the mobs won't drop into these hoppers or anything and be able to see you from there either. So when we get down here, we will place the one there and also place the one here. So we're going to head back up to the top. And now to turn the farm on, we're going to put 45 items in this hopper. We're going to get down here and we're going to break our scaffolding down to here. Then we're going to go down. We'll break the rest from the bottom when we're ready for the mobs to start falling on us. The water from those dispensers will push the other torches off that we have in there, so we don't have to worry about getting rid of those. Now we just place a trapdoor there, and once the water pushes the mobs, they should start falling in. And now that the farm is running, it's time to grind some XP and finally get some of our stuff enchanted here. Alrighty, so I have done quite a bit of enchanting. I also replaced the trapdoors on the hoppers with slabs that helps prevent them from seeing me a little bit better so they don't actually target me, unless I'm like right in the corner there. So, first off, we have our sword, which has everything except for mending. That took quite a bit of work to get. We have a bow with everything except for punch 2, which we can get eventually, but it's not the biggest deal in the world. We have Protection 4 Diamond Helmet, Protection 4 Diamond Chestplate, Unbreaking 3 and Protection 4 Diamond Leggings, and Protection 3 and Feather Falling 4 Diamond Boots. Then we also have a pretty good Silk Touch pick, and another one just like it over here. Then we also have a really good Fortune pick, so we can get more diamonds now. I have some waiting in one of my caves for me to mine with this. We also have a Silk Touch Shovel. And then we have a few enchanted books up here that we got when we didn't have anything else to enchant. So yeah. So now that we're all geared up, I want to do a tiny bit more exploring before we end this episode. Also, take a look at our nasty looking mob farm up there. So I went exploring a little bit this way earlier because some pillagers spawned around here and I wanted them to despawn. And off a little ways into the desert here, I found two azalea trees, which means there are lush caves around here. So I do want to go down into those, probably not fully explore them today, but I do want to at least get the moss, the glowberries, and maybe some of the drip leaves and the spore blossoms. That's what they are. So I want to bring some of those home. And then I also want to try and find a taiga and a roofed forest because I do want to get the other kinds of wood. So here we are coming up on the azalea trees. There's one right here and then one right over there. So they're not too far apart. So it's definitely the same cave system. It's right by this jungle over here too, which has some cool hills and stuff over there, which we may do something with for a build at some point. But that is not today. So we're gonna spiral our way down beneath this tree and see if we can find the lush caves that we are promised. So, going through and editing this video, I realized I must have forgotten to hit record when I actually made it into the caves, unfortunately. There wasn't too much to show there. It was a pretty small cave. We did get our glowberries and moss, though, and a couple drip leaves. And we also have an axolotl in a bucket, so that's cool. And we also found at the very end of the cave a couple of dripstone. So not very much. This was all that was in the cave. Two blocks and a point. But I assume if we probably break through the ends of the cave, we'll probably run into more, so we may go back there at some point. So to look for our other tree types, I think I'm gonna head this way back towards where we spawned. And we're gonna see if we can find them over here. Because I'm assuming back towards the jungle is more warm biomes, but it could switch over, but it's gonna be difficult navigating that jungle, and I don't necessarily want to do that at the moment. Plus, I haven't really gone over this way. So we'll see what we can find. There's the ocean monument I mentioned earlier, so it's actually pretty close to spawn. That's our spawn island right over there. So, pretty close to spawn. Oh wow. Actually, the first island I've seen since going over here is Mushroom Island. So that is also pretty close to spawn. Not even 1,000 blocks away. Nice. Let's pick up some mycelium while we're here, since this is right here. Might as well bring some home. This is some pretty interesting terrain here. Nice big sunflower plains hill. Looks like there's a forest up there. Ooh, so this is actually one of the big mountains, and it's actually a flower forest over here, so that's interesting. So if we ever wanted to get powder snow or something, I believe we can get it up there. Actually curious to see how far this mountain range goes, because this could be a pretty interesting spot to build as well. Looks like it continues over here as well. Yeah, this is definitely a really neat spot. Here's the coordinates if you guys want to see it for yourself. There's another mountain over here, so there's that one, and that one. I mean, there's a lot going on here. This is really cool terrain. This is definitely going to be a building spot at some point. And then it all just drops off around here, a giant cliff. Looks like there's a big cave over there too, and a village. And this kind of loops in here. Definitely some cool stuff we could do with this. And not too far from there's actually spruce trees and ice spikes, so we may be able to do an ice farm or something over here. Maybe worth it to pick some of this up while we're over here, actually. I also love how in 1.18 you can have these massive lakes, especially in these frozen areas where it all turns into ice. You can just skate across it. Pretty cool things that you wouldn't see before. Ooh, and there's a pillager outpost here. I don't see those too often. So let's mark down those coordinates. Boom. Aha, I see the roofed forest over there. And we found a Mega Taiga, by the way. So that's cool. And we are back home in our little storage room that is not very pretty yet. But that will change at some point. And I'm probably going to have to go ahead and end the episode here for today. We got quite a bit done. Still have lots more to do. I'll probably do some more mining off camera now that I've got that fortune pick. And see what we can get from that. I also possibly want to stream sometime. I'm not sure when I want to start that. I don't know if exploring the rest of these caves around here would be interesting for that, or if I'll do it more when I start building. But I wanted to get the question out there. If I do start streaming, what would you guys like to see on it? And what platform would you like to see it on, either Twitch or YouTube? Because I do have set up for both. So whenever we start streaming, whatever you guys would prefer is where I'll start, because I'm not too sure myself where I'd like to stream. So let me know in the comments what you think. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.